Welcome to Sunday worship service at Paola United Methodist Church. Grace of Lord Jesus Christ to be with you all. We all gather together here for worship God, and we are here to worship and praise God. Let us praise and give our God glory, honor for giving us opportunity to be here so that we can share Christ's love together. Let us open our hearts and minds and praise and worship God together, and let us come before the Lord with the opening prayer. Loving God, thank you for your forgiveness and leading us to bring all our worries to you. We also thank you for hearing our cries and comforting us with your love, protecting us with your everlasting arms. We are truly, you are truly the rock of our salvation and refuge. So even though we live in the dark, we wake in the morning with joy, peace, and love within you. Bless each one of us gathered here to worship and praise. Be with us among our worship. Jesus Christ, the holy name, we pray. Amen. Okay, yeah.
All of you on this beautiful holiday weekend, 4th of July, yeah. Big deal.
Big deal.
Anybody see any firecrackers or anything go in the air last night?
I heard that.
Oh, yeah. Boom, boom, all the way around here. So we're off to a good start here. Well, if you look on the inside of your bulletins, on the inside on the left-hand side there, there's a whole list of things that need our attention. First of all, Vacation Bible School. Been 2 or 3 years since we've had Vacation Bible School. And it's one of the things that little kids seem to enjoy. If you've got kids or neighbors or friends or anybody, it doesn't have to be Methodist, just anybody, little kids can come, and it's can be a fun thing for them. So work on that if you would. And then the next thing here, this is the week we've been waiting for. The elevator parts are supposed to be shipped this week. I'm thinking maybe we could maybe set up some chairs out here and kind of watch when the truck shows up and kind of make a ceremonial deal out of this maybe. Could, what do you think? Maybe a potluck dinner with it.
Oh, really? Okay.
Well, we'll think that over. Anyway, we hope this all works out, and we're looking forward to seeing some action. Even though it's going to be inconvenient for a while, it's something that has to be done. And then there's the toothpaste issue, the SOS kits for our students. We're trying to raise lots of toothpaste tubes here, and the details are in this little square. And then watch next week. It looks like it's time to do the backpacks for back to school, so a lot of opportunities here to get involved in collections like that. And then you see here's a note, too, about the wood bookcase. It's down here in the Connecting Center. There's a bookcase that's been collecting space in the basement for quite some time, and the ladies in the this and that shop would really like to have somebody have a new home for it. It's a pretty nice wooden bookcase. If you need something to fill it up with, maybe they would even fill it full of free books.
Oh, yeah.
That would be a good thing. Or you could take it home, put paint cans on it or flower pots. So it's a nice piece of furniture, and it really needs a new home really bad. And then the one that caught my attention here was the Pie Festival. I've never been to a pie festival, but I think this is going to be a big deal. Now, it's not till October, but just look at that. Mark your calendars for the pie auction, games, food, and fellowship. Could this possibly be the makings for a Hallmark movie? Well, maybe not. But anyway, and then also it's in the list of the upcoming events here in the calendar here, but on the 16th, it says July 16th, United Methodist Men FICA meeting. FICA, we had one of those last summer. And if you forgot what FICA means, it means coffee break. And that's going to be at Snoffer's Backyard coming up on Saturday morning, the 16th. So men, we'd like to have you put that on your calendar. So I guess that kind of takes any other announcements from the crowd this morning. If not, then if you please rise, greet each other, and let's... Whoa, wait a minute.
Okay.
Oh, George has got something.
We're taking reservations for riding the parade float So you better get your reservation made quick. Seats are going fast. We'd like to have a dozen people on there. So sign right up with the office or me or John Huff or anybody that around here. We'll get your name on the list. Need some riders. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay. Thanks, George. Okay, let's rise and greet each other and welcome to our church.
Good morning.
Let's all turn to our hymnals this morning now on number 98. Our opening hymn is "To God Be the Glory." If you join us together in the call to worship, the words are up on the screens. Sing praises to God, O faithful ones.
Give thanks and proclaim God's holy name.
Weeping or joyful, mourning or dancing.
Come as you are, for all are welcome here.
Open your hearts to healing, to life restored.
Let us worship God. Amen. Please be seated.
Please turn your hymnals to number 707, Hymn of Promise. The words will also be on the screen.
Apple tree in cocoons.
Children, can I invite the children come forward? And Reina, can you come forward and for the children moment?
Good morning. How are you guys this morning?
Good.
Now, tomorrow is a special day. Do you know what tomorrow is? The 4th of July. That we call it, you call it the 4th of July, so does everybody else, but its real name is Independence Day. So, tomorrow is Independence Day. Do you know what that means? Yeah. Do you know why we call it Independence Day? Okay, it's because you do? It is because we left a country that would try to rule us. Well, if you listen carefully, okay? And so we left a country that tried to rule us. We didn't think they were treating us very fair, so we declared our independence or our freedom from that country. And so now we celebrate that every year. Do you know that we also get freedom when we believe in Jesus? It says the Spirit will be with us and give us freedom. When we, you know, when we do things we shouldn't do, you know, things that aren't very good, and that sort of makes us feel bad. So we say to Jesus, we say that we're sorry that we've done those things that He's not very proud of us doing, and so we will try not to do those again, and so Jesus forgives us, and that makes us feel free. Just like we were free from that country. Oh, now. Would that be a thing that Jesus would want us to do? So let's not do that, okay? Let's be nice to our brother. Okay? So, we celebrate Independence Day, but with Jesus we celebrate the fact that He loves us enough to forgive us for the bad things that we do, okay? So, shall we say a quick prayer? Okay. Dear Heavenly Father, help us to do things that are right, that please You, so that we can feel free in Your love. Help us to help others find Jesus. and love him too. In Jesus' name, amen. Okay. So you can celebrate our country's freedom, okay? Well, which of these others would you like? You want that one or one of these? Okay. All right. You can go back.
Anybody have any joys they'd like to share with us this morning? I'd like to start off by complimenting the church on the fun picnic inside with the air conditioner last week. And lots of good Methodist food there, and that was a nice event. So thank you all for coming and participating. Are there any other joys in the crowd here? Glenn?
I'm happy to have my daughter, Julia, and her daughters, Enslin and Sienna, here from Idaho.
All the way from Idaho. Glad to have you folks here today.
Welcome.
Anybody else?
Okay.
Yes.
I am Catherine Ezell, and this is my husband, Rick. We are from Galena, Kansas, which is just across the state line from Joplin, Missouri. We are here camping because a week ago Wednesday, Rick had a liver transplant at KU Medical Center, and he is doing awesome, but we have to stay close, so that's why we're camping. And I'm just so thrilled to be here because Methodist churches are just so much alike. We have those same kind of kids right there at our church. So that just made us feel at home. So we appreciate the chance of being here.
Welcome to our service.
Well, thank you for being here. Did you say from Burlington?
Galena.
Yes, okay, that makes sense. Well, anyway, we're glad that our church showed up here for you to come participate in, and we're glad to have you folks with us. And good luck in your surgery, your liver thing. So that's great. Anybody else? Are there any concerns in the crowd this morning? Anything we need to share about?
Gail?
Yes, where are we at here?
I'm up here.
Oh, the man upstairs.
So I... So I'd like to ask for prayers for our family. I've got a pretty good list. I received word last Sunday during services. I lost my Aunt Shirley Wagner, who lived in Virginia. She passed away. Connie received word on Friday that she lost her Aunt Joyce Parker in San Diego, California. Connie's mom went to the hospital last night with some heart flutter, but she's back home again. But most of all, we'd like to ask prayers. Her brother on Tuesday will undergo open heart surgery to repair an aneurysm and a valve replacement. So prayers for him while they go through all that.
Wow, that's quite a full plate, James.
It is.
Thank you for sharing that with us, and we all hope that it all works well. Yes, Jen.
Hi, I'd like to ask for prayers for Reva. She's one of the caregivers for Kevin's parents. Her brother had a massive heart attack yesterday. He's not doing well. They don't expect him to survive. The family is with him today. So prayers for them and their family for the grace of God. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Thank you for that. Anybody else?
Sorry, I don't mean to take over here, but we always want to remember the donor family. And so we're rejoicing, but we understand that they're going through a loss also. So please remember donor families.
Thank you.
If not, Pastor?
Joel?
Okay, one way. Okay. Oh, yeah, okay. Joel.
I just wanted to remember people affected by the anthrax accident.
Oh, yeah, that's a huge, huge accident. Seems like there's always something in the news, isn't it, about a major catastrophe someplace. Never okay. ends.
Okay.
Okay, next.
All right. Please join me in prayer. Gracious and loving God, we come with a thankful heart, knowing that through your Son, we can come and speak directly to you without the need for sacrifice. We thank you for the calling you have placed on our lives. Thank you for your love, for your protection, and for your guidance. We would like to take time now to lift it up this nation to you. We thank you for the blessing of liberty for this generation, for the generation to come. We thank you for our independence and peace, and for all those who have bravely given their lives in the defense of freedom and justice. God, we pray for your continuous presence, guidance, and grace for our country, our land, people, and industries are in need of you. May we look only to you this Independence Day, dependence on you. We also lift it up our church family, friends, and those on our prayer list, and those about whom we are concerned and who are in our hearts. God, you know each need and burden. We pray for your physical, emotional, and spiritual healing for them. We pray for your holy comforts and peace that passes all understanding to come into their lives and heal their wounds. We pray for the protection of many people's lives in Ukraine. We ask for your redeeming love and mercy in this situation. May Ukraine not lose hope and find peace, safety, comfort, truth, and freedom. We pray for God's intervention to stop the war as soon as possible. God, we know you have a vision for this church. Help us to listen to your voice and strengthen unity and harmony among us so that we are continuously enabled us to accomplish your will through our ministries. Give us eyes and heart to see your eyes that we may bring hope, peace to the world. God, this is a vacation season. Many church members are on vacation and planning to travel. We pray for their safe trips. Please protect them wherever they are and whatever they do. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen.
Please turn in your hymnal to in your black hymnal to 2039, verses 1 and 4. Our words of course will also be on the screen.
Just like to mention a reminder to fill out the connection cards in the bulletin and leave in your church pews or put them in a collection plate or so we can keep a record of who all's here. It's now time for sharing of our tithes and offerings. As usual, there are plates in the back and on the sides and lots of opportunities electronically to do that. We're supporting the church and the many things that goes on here. So please rise for the doxology.
Thank you.
please join me in prayers. Dear God, bless these tithes and offering and transform them into compassion for the love and compassion for the needy and the others. Please help us use your gifts for transform your word and for the church and around us. Jesus Christ, the holy name we pray. Amen. Please be seated.
And now it's time for George Deem and the Ensemble. We look forward every week to having this group play for us, and I bet we got something patriotic today. Nice. Thank you, group, for sharing that with us this morning. And now, Emma, we're glad to have you with us again this morning. We thank you for all you do to make our service good. Emma's got the scripture for us this morning.
Would you please rise for the reading of the scripture? Today's scripture reading is from Psalms 30, verses 1 through 12. I will exalt you, Lord, for you lifted me out of the depths and did not let my enemies gloat over me. Lord my God, I called to you for help and you healed me. You, Lord, brought me up from the realm of the dead. You spared me from going down to the pit. Sing the praises of the Lord, you his faithful people. Praise his holy name. For his anger lasts only a minute, but his favor lasts a lifetime. Weeping may stay for the night, but rejoicing comes in the morning. When I felt secure, I said, I will never be shaken. Lord, when you favored me, you made my royal mountains stand firm. But when you hid your face, I was dismayed. To you, Lord, I called. To the Lord, I cried for mercy. What is gained if I am silenced? If I go down to the pit, will the dust praise you? Will it proclaim your faithfulness? Hear, Lord, and be merciful to me. Lord, be my help. You turned my wailing into dancing. You removed my sackcloth and clothed me with joy, that my heart may sing your praises and not be silent. Lord my God, I will praise you forever. This has been the word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God. Please be seated. Tomorrow is Independence Day, also called the 4th of July or July 4th. I think Independence Day will be the one of the biggest national holiday in the U.S., and even people outside of the U.S. can see it. You might see a lot of fireworks shows held in many states, so watching various types of fireworks together with your family members and friends and people around us will be fun. And we know that when we share our joy, it makes it double. So we will be excited to celebrate together. And it will be the gospel blessing for us to delight in the freedom with the people on a special day. When I was a high school student, I had a chance to learn American history. It's about the Boston Tea incident. I never thought about the tea was such an expensive item that back then, and it could be the reason why this incident happened. Historically, America was one of the 13 colonies of Great Britain. However, Great Britain tried to impose high taxation without the representation, so they dumped 342 chests of tea imported by the British East India Company into the Boston Harbor. It appealed to protest the British Parliament tax on tea. The crisis escalated, and the American Revolutionary War began near Boston in 1775. Finally, Congress voted to approve the independence of America on July 2nd, and adopted a Declaration of Independence 2 days later, which is July 4th, 1776. Comparing my country, South Korea, we celebrate Independence Day on August 15. It is one of the happiest days after 35 years of being colonized by Japan. Everybody came out of their homes with a shout for victory, and then joy with tears. On the other hand, we do not celebrate Korean Independence Day as American people do, because there are many people, innocent people, suffered and died and persecuted by Japanese government. Japan invaded Korea because the Korea Peninsula was the center of the land to extend their territory through China, Russia, and Southeast Asia. They forced the Korean people to change the name into Japanese name, and they were forcefully recruited to provide labor for Japan, and drafted into the Japanese army toward the end of the Second World War. And Korean men were forced to fight on the front line for Japan and were sent to work in the Japanese factories. And while many Korean young women were drafted as a comforted woman for Japanese soldiers. Thus, it was one of the most unfortunate periods in Korea history. During Japanese oppression, many Koreans stood up against it and often paid for their lives. March 1st, 1919 was the time of one of the critical uprising of this period. When that day, several Korean nationalists declared Korea independent. However, the struggle for independence continued for another 25 years until Korea gained its freedom. The day Korean finally threw off its Japanese rulers is known as National Liberation Day of Korea or Korean Independence Day. In 1945, Korea was finally liberated from its occupation by Japan. This day, Japan was defeated in the World War II with the help of Allied troops of the United States and the Soviet Union at that time to end 35 years of colonial denominational over the territory of a peninsula. Likewise, Independence Day is a momentous day. And that reminds us of how important freedom is. However, the most important thing is God is always wanted to have a freedom and rescue us from the enemy's hands. We can find an excellent example in the Exodus. God delivered the Israelites from Egypt's slavery through Moses. So they finally saw the light of God's grace. Thus, Independence Day is the when the light returned, like a light of dawn. And so it was a beginning of a new day and the end of a darkness of a night and the restoration of a nation. Again, if we go back to today's text, it makes us think about what the spiritual freedom in God is all about. Psalm chapter 30 is called a Songs of Dedication of the Temple of David. Even though King David could not build a temple in his lifetime, then why would the Israelites recite Psalm chapter 30 whenever they rebuilt the temple? To answer this, we needed to think about the temple's function first. The temple was a place where the Israelites could meet God. Historically, it was where people offer their sacrifice to God. It will be the same as our worship service every Sunday at the church. Then why do we come to church and worship and praise our God every Sunday? We can get the answer in verse 1. It says, I will exalt you, Lord, for you lift me out of the depths and did not let my enemies gloat over me. It revealed that worship is exalting the Lord because God pulls us out of the depths of darkness and the bondage of our sins. The word pulls out in Hebrew is dola, is used to express emergency rescue 911. And for instance, when a person falls deep into the well, the person might desperately call out for rescue all night. Thus, the word dola is an action verb. It is used when people pull a person out of a deep well. Then, when did you feel trapped by the deep well in your life? The deep well can be our struggle and trouble, suffering, and agony. However, when we were trapped by deep well, and we could not even think about how to come out of it by our strength and our will and power. So whenever we realize it's impossible, then people usually look up the sky to help, for cry out for help. Thus we could cry out to God for help, and God will hear us and reach out his mighty hands for us and rescue us from the deep well. Amen. It makes us feel thankful that God always watches over us and is ready to save us and whenever we are in dangerous situation. Therefore, when we worship and praise our God, we can bring every troubles and worry to God. And we can acknowledge that we are saved through Jesus Christ with God's grace. So we are free from our sins. So people can be more grateful when they realize their sins are great. It leads us to exalt our Lord with all our hearts, minds, and strengths, as well as truth. However, when we think our sins are not that great, we might think that we can come out of pits with our strength and power, but then we might not feel grateful. Thus, it makes us not to focus on God, leading us to think about many other things during the worship service. I don't believe my congregation is not doing this, but some people do. Other church, not this Paola. Don't get me wrong. For instance, people might think, what will have for lunch? And checking the grocery shopping list. Some of us might check the email, text message during worship service. I don't see anybody, okay? Put your phone down. And make us forget about the God's grace. And important sometimes it's very important to waiting for the message from others. And it will be a dangerous sign that we have logic between God and us. It makes us forget about the God's grace and love. In contrast, when we feel like we're in 400 feet down of a pit, we realize that we could not come out of our trouble without help from others. So then if someone found us and rescued us, and we never forget them throughout our lives. Therefore, our salvation will be like this. And we should remember what price paid up to save us from our sins. We are saved by the blood of Jesus Christ. It is precious blood to conquer our sins and give us eternal salvation. God came to the earth with a human body and gave up all his glory in heaven. So it was a great punishment for God. Not only that, God shed blood on the cross and endured all sufferings and pain until all the waters and blood came out from his body. It shows how serious our sins were, and we were such a great sinners. Thus, we should remember that we cannot even think about our salvation without that cross. However, the problem is that people often forget how great our God's love is and how our salvation is precious and a valuable gift for us. Amen. Nevertheless, God never gave up on us and continuously reached out God's mighty hands to rescue us from the pit of our sins and make us God's children. So God makes our enemy cannot gloat over us. It means that God never let our enemy rejoice in our suffering, but punish them with God's ways. Then who are our enemies? It can be our death, sickness, troubles, and many people, any people who are happy to see our sufferings and hope us not to go well. They might also mock us and ask us to prove how our lives change after believing God. Our enemy do not say anything when we are doing well. However, if they find something problem, they start attacking us as if they were waiting for this. They might say, I have known that you would have a trouble since you have said, I believe in God. Thus, they will point out us and laugh at us because money, wealth, and honor are their God, so they do not believe in God. However, God never allowed our enemy to prosper. But instead, God make them how who God is with God's ways. Thus, Isaiah chapter 1, it says, so do not fear, for I am with you. Do not be dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you and help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand. When we experience how God rescued us from many enemies, hands and any dangerous situation, our worship will be very powerful. We will not lose our hearts in any other circumstances, but lead us to praise our God with all our hearts and minds and strengths. It should be our worship and how we can give thanks to God because it gives us spiritual freedom. Therefore, when we come here to worship, I hope we can realize we are all great sinners. But God rescue us from our sins. Otherwise, we might struggle with sin without knowing our destination. Amen. I hope we remember we are free from our sin every day, which makes us feel grateful to God. Without God's love, mercy, and grace, we never are here to worship in this place in this hour. God gives us the strength to praise and worship God, and it is our true blessing. Therefore, when we realize our spiritual freedom in God, we can confess that God turns our wailing into dancing. God removes our sackcloth and clothes us with joy. Thus, we never get exhausted, even though we dance and sing praise with all our hearts, minds, and strengths, because we can acknowledge how marvelous and great our God's love and grace is for us. Amen. God works for us and shows us who God is in our lives. If there is no Jesus sacrifice, we will all die without eternal salvation. Surely Jesus, our God, saved us, and our crying sadness turned into dance because God moved our sackcloth and clothed us with joy and wiped out all our tears so that every day will be our spiritual independence day for us. Amen. For this reason, King David confessed in verse 12, my heart may sing my God praises, not be silent. Lord, my God, I will praise you forever. I hope we all praise and worship God like a King David. And I hope we all cannot help but be thankful because everyday life is joy and blessing and miracle. Does God continuously call us in this place of worship and make us sing praise with all our hearts and minds and strengths? Therefore, we can stand in Jesus' name because God gives us strength. And even though Satan may come against us, we will not surround the ground because we can stand with the power and strength in God alone. It is how we can walk with the power of God every day in our lives. Amen. Amen. We have a communion today. Do you have a booklet with you in your bulletin? I will go through the confession of a faith and I will bless the elements. I will ask some question before we partake of the communion. In celebration Holy Communion, we are reminded of the new beginning made Allah available to us through the birth of Jesus Christ and the work of the Holy Spirit, are called to dedicate ourselves as Jesus' disciple, continuing his ministry in this world. We have been empowered by your Holy Spirit, called to renounce the evil, repent of our sins, accept the gift of God's power, confess Christ as our Savior, and nurture one another. On behalf of Jesus Christ and the church the world over, I will ask you, do you renounce the spiritual force of weakness, reject the evil powers of this world, and repent of your sin? Do you accept the freedom and power God gives you, and will you resist the evil, injustice, and oppression in whatever forms they present themselves? Do you confess Jesus Christ as your Savior, put your whole trust in his grace, long faithfully for his coming, and promise to serve him as your Lord, in union with the church the world over? Will you nurture each other and your community in Christ the Holy Church, that by your teaching and example you each may be guided to accept God's grace, to profess your faith openly, and to lead our Christian life? With God's help, you will proclaim the good news and live according to the example of Christ. We will surround each other with a community of love and forgiveness and seek to live each day as a living proclamation of our facing Jesus Christ in faithfulness to example he set for us. Amen. Let us approach the communion table with the assurance of those who have been accepted into the kingdom of God. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and a good and joyful things, always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator, heaven and earth. And so with your people on earth and all the company of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Holy are you and blessed your Son Jesus Christ. By the baptism of your his suffering, death, and resurrection, you gave birth to your church, gave us a new beginning, delivered us from slavery to your sin, thus filled us with your Holy Spirit, and made with us a new covenant by the water and the Spirit. On the night in which he gave himself for us, he took the bread, gave thanks to you, and broke the bread, and gave it to his disciple and said, this is my body is broken for you. Do this as remembrance of me. When supper was over, he took the cup, he gave a thing to you, and gave to his disciple and said, drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of a new covenant poured out for you and for many for forgiveness of sin. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. And so in remembrance of these your mighty acts in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and living sacrifice in union with the Christ offering for us as we proclaim the mystery of your faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Pour out your Holy Spirit on us gathered here on these gifts of bread and wine. Make them be for us the body and blood of Christ, that we may be for the world the body of Christ, redeemed by his blood. By your Spirit, make us be a new creation, born anew in Christ Jesus, together in communion with each other, and united in the mystery to the whole world, until Christ comes in final victory and ministry to the whole faithful together at his heavenly banquet. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in your holy church, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. Let us, confident children of God, let us pray the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. I will ask the ushers to come forward to help us to distribute the communion table. As you know, the United Methodist Church do open communion. The table is open to anyone. Seek to respond to Christ's love and grace. And everyone here today worship, regardless of ages and what denomination you belong to, what church you attended, we all welcome to Christ's table. The bread represents Christ's body broken for us. The juice represents Christ's blood shed for us. Christ's table is ready. And if you are not able to come forward, please raise your hand. We will going to serve you where you are seated. Christ's table is ready. Please come forward. We will start from the back row, please. This is the body of Christ broken for you. This is the body of Christ broken for you. This is the body of Christ broken for you. This is the body of Christ broken for you. This is the body of Christ broken for you. This is the body of Christ broken for you. This is the body of Christ broken for you. This is the body of Christ broken for you. This is the body of Christ broken for you. This is the body of Christ broken for you. This is the body of Christ broken for you. This is the body of Christ broken for you. This is the body of Christ broken for you. This is the body of Christ broken for you. This is the body of Christ broken for you. This is the body of Christ broken for you. This is the body of Christ broken for you. This is the body of Christ broken for you. This is the body of Christ broken for you.
This is the body of Christ broken for you. This is the body of Christ broken for you. This is the body of Christ broken for you. This is the body of Christ broken for you. This is the body of Christ broken for you. This is the body of Christ broken for you. This is the body of Christ broken for you. This is the body of Christ broken for you. This is the body of Christ broken for you. This is the body of Christ broken for you. Hold up. This is the body of Christ broken for you. 엄마, 빨리 와. 빨리 와. This is the body of Christ broken for you. 엄마, 빵 집어. This is the body of Christ broken for you. 엄마, 가서 저기서 먹어. 일로 가지. This is the body of Christ broken for you. JR. JR. Okay, Junior. Okay. Go to Junior and his son. Junior, this is the body of Christ broken for you.
Please turn in your hymnal and rise for our closing hymn, America the Beautiful.
From sea.
following Sunday, I will continue to preach my sermon series in July, Walking in the Power of God. God is, was, will be, is, and will be with us always. Go in peace with a joyful heart. God goes with you everywhere you go. And the love of God guides your life journey. The love of Jesus with you, your Holy Spirit, guides you always. Have a blessed Independence Day and have a fun. May God bless you all. Amen.
Thought by day.